Chairman Sixto Brillantes, he's still on the line. Let's get him back. Chairman, magandang umaga po muli. Sorry about that.
Oh, Pinky. I just read your doorstep. Just wanted to say, no, they might have acted on it without acting on the mandatory resolution which we came out.
Yeah,
I did not hear.
Yung A.
Wala yung A. Meron yes. kaming in-issue kahapon na A.
Yes, I saw that, sir.
Supplemental. So,
opo.
Mukhang hindi nila na rin o hindi nasama sa petition.
But Chairman,
we just clarified in the Supreme Court. So.
You want to clarify that? The supplemental
yes.
Resolution?
But anyway, it's already Friday. So, in the meantime, we will have to recognize the TROS. The only thing is, based on what I heard from Theodore T., there was no mention of the supplemental
yeah.
resolution that came out yesterday, which is my A unit, supplemental to 9688A. That's not touching the TRO. So there might be some confusion only there. But we will not touch this anymore. So I don't think we're coming to the weekend. We don't want to confuse anymore. We will just not implement it. I'll talk to the other commissioners.
All right. So that should end the story there, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Tapos na po yung story sa money ban. All right, Chairman, any problems that you foresee? Ano pa ho ba ang kailangan gawin over the weekend before Monday's election?
Wala na ho. Ang pakiusap ko lang sana yung aking mga kaibigan, kagaya ni Gus, saka yung Mr. Magdamo na salita ng salita. Sana naman, we're only 3 days away. Imbis na nag-aaway pa kami. No, ngayon, kung ano sinasabi, meron sinasabi na mas maganda pa raw yung hindi raw natin makikita yung binoto natin sa PICOS. Hindi ko alam kung bumaboto si Gus nung manual, kung mumabalik siya after he votes in the morning or in the afternoon, whether he goes back there during the counting and whether he can see whether what he voted for is to be the son of teacher. Wala kang effect yan eh. Hindi ko maintindihan. Pag-alawa, we're talking about so many things. But since the time we approved the option to purchase, all the issues are legal. And it is always Gus who has been dissenting on legal matters. In fact, he even argued in the Supreme Court on the option to purchase. Pero legal hindi naman ang issue, mga technical. He keeps on coming out with so many legal matters. Eh, sana naman wag naman ganun. Sabi ko nga, ako ay try to avoid discussions on technical. Let's start. Ano ang ginawa ni Gus sa amin dito in 10 months? 500 cases ang resolved niya. Together with us. Puro legal yun. Napakarami niyang ginawa legal, although he's not a lawyer. Anong ginawa naman niya sa technical? Wala ako nakita. Except siguro yung CCS. May ginawa siya. Hindi pa namin in-approve dahil hindi naman po pwede. So, sana naman sa mahimik na tatlong araw na lang. And debate all of this after Monday. Taposin natin to, we can debate with all of these things instead of we creating some doubts, stating speculations. Huwag naman ganon. 3 days na lang eh. Nandiyan pa eh.
Alright.
Panong konti.
Okay.
And tama na naman. Tama na.
Alright. Well, Chairman.
Okay with me.
Okay. Well, Chairman, kahapon, at least, you know, one of the bigger problems, yung source code ay na-turn over na naman. So, you know, we carried that live here on ANC, sir. So, that's...
Let's say, 1 week ago, 2 weeks ago, he was talking to Kabayan, and he was saying that we will not be able to solve this because there is no source code. Magkakaroon ng problema yung mga protesta kasi walang source code, hindi malalaman kung ano mali. So, which means, kung magkakaroon ng source code, mayroon, it can be used sa protest, which means it's also important that even after the elections, the source code could be used.
All right.
So, why are they saying now that it's coming in too late? Wala na, hindi naman eh.
Mm.
It's not too late.
It can still be used. Yeah. All right.
In 2010, the AS Watch wanted to look at it even after the election. So, tama pala balibaliktad. So, everybody is getting confused. This one, your Ted Pailon, interview si Magdamo. Magdamo, I'm not seeing his face in this commission, and yet he knows so many things that's happening here. Gus Lapan, I've not seen him in this commission, but he's been talking about so many things. So, sila ang naririnig. No, wala naman sila nga na kami 24-7 kami rito araw-araw. Hindi naman kami naging ikay from the outside na wala naman kami naralaman ang nangyayari dito sa loob. Puro kalkulasyon lang, speculation, doubts, kwan. Okay. Just help us.
All right. Well, Chairman, of course, good luck. Everything at least could be ready, should be ready for Monday's elections. Of course, not just to the COMELEC, but all to the all to all members of the COMELEC, the teachers, the Board of Election Inspectors, those teachers involved there, lahat po ng political parties, lahat at lahat po ng boboto. Of course, we're hoping for a clean, honest, and peaceful election. Chairman Sixto Brillantes, sir, thank you so much. Thank you.